He's a fanatic. I mean, we've heard from his ex-wife, by the way, in newspapers, the Washington Post and elsewhere. He beat her up. He was a... He apparently had no religious, strong religious convictions whatsoever. And what we often get is a situation, people went to Syria, what's the first book they buy off Amazon? Islam for Dummies. People like this will select and choose from religion or otherwise to justify their bigotry.
That's my point. A lot of the people, again, you've gone off to fight in Syria and Iraq, they're looking for something. They've got something missing in their lives. They're looking for something. But this guy, by whatever reason you do it, if you kill 50 people, you are a lunatic. And to a certain extent...
Let's just return to the fact that in LA, the gay pride event has passed off without an attack.
Despite
but again, there was an arrest of person
who wasn't a Muslim.
We don't know what the, as far as we know, with explosives in a car and arms as well. So, you know, clearly there is the question about whether there is a, as you say, a hate crime or whether something's being done in the name of religion.
It's both.
And we do have
I'm
to
sure.
try and delineate
people, look,
the
people
two.
Rationalise their hatred. This guy, apparently, according to his dad, saw two men kissing and he was repulsed by it. And people know this who are gay, that there are people out there who are sickened and repulsed by our very existence. And this guy, however he dresses up his bigotry and hatred, is somebody who hates gays. He hates LGBT people. And he had a gun, and because of, as you say, America's gun laws, he used that to murder LGBT people. But can we just be clear, just so, because you say it's lunatics and all the rest of it, we've got to be clear, if he went into a synagogue and killed innocent Jewish people, as we've got mass people in the past who've done that, disgusting anti-Semitic terrorists, we would call it out for what it is. This person is a homophobic terrorist, whatever else he is. Presumably he's got some twisted view of Islamic fundamentalism to justify his, even though he's just a knuckle-dragging thug and bigot. At the end of the day, this was a homophobic hate crime as well as terrorism. Has to be called up because I have to say, on Sky News and other lots of news channels, there's not been many LGBT voices that I've personally heard myself. And people have to understand, as LGBT people watching this and elsewhere, that they look at something like this and it is one of the worst atrocities committed against LGBT people in the Western world for generations.
Well, it has to be called out.
It's
something that's carried out against human beings, isn't it? No matter
Let's
just make this point that you cannot say this is a worse attack than what happened in Paris.